Okay, so this is another Stokes Theorem problem. You're given a line integral with the vector field and the curve, and we're asked to solve using Stokes Theorem. So again, like last time, since we're given the curve, we're going to want to evaluate it as a surface integral using this equation. So the curve integral equals the curl of the vector field dot n ds, and we're going to have to calculate these three parts. Okay, so let me sketch the curve here on the side. The curve is a triangle going counterclockwise. It's 1 on y and 2 on the z. So the surface is going to be a plane, if we imagine the curve as a surface, and the normal vector goes out kind of like that. All right, so probably one of the first things that we can do is solve for the curl of the vector field. That equals del crossed with the vector field. So that's going to be a matrix I, j, k. Del is partial, partial x, partial, partial y, partial, partial z. And just to simplify the notation, we can call these the components p, q, r, just to make it easier to write in the matrix. So p, q, r, that's going to equal partial r, partial y, minus partial q, partial z, minus the j component, which is partial r, partial x, minus partial p, partial z, plus the k component, which is partial q, partial x, minus partial p, partial y. All right, so let me just solve that over here. Partial r, partial q is 0, minus partial q, partial z, that's going to be 6, minus the j component. J is partial r, partial x, it's 3, minus 0, plus the k component, partial q, partial x, 0 again, and partial p, partial y is 1. So the curl of the vector field is negative 6, negative 3, negative 1. Next, we're going to want to find the unit normal vector to do the dot product. So we're going to want to take another cross product. So the points that were given were 2, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 2. From these points, we want to make two lines. So again, let's just call this P, Q, R. Two lines would be, for example, PQ and PR. And again, the idea is we're going to take two lines from the plane, do the cross product. That'll give us a vector, and then we want to find the unit vector of that. Let's just subtract from the coordinates to get the lines. So 0 minus 2 is going to be negative 2, 1 minus 0 is 1, and 0. PR is 0 minus 2, negative 2, 0, and 2. Okay, so now let's take the cross product of PQ and line PR. So we can imagine it like that. And again, we know that that will give us a normal vector. So IJK again, that's going to be negative 2, 1, 0, negative 2, 0, 2. Alright, so that will give us 2 minus 0 minus the j component, which is negative 4 minus 0, plus k component 0 minus negative 2. So that's going to give us 2, 4, 2. To find the unit normal vector, we're going to take v over the magnitude of v. V is just this vector that we found, so that equals the normal vector. The magnitude will be the square root of 2 squared plus 4 squared plus 2 squared. So that's going to give us 2 over the square root of 24, 4 over the square root of 24, and 2 over the square root of 24. Okay, so we have the curl of the vector field, we have the normal vector. The next part of the equation that we want to worry about is the ds. In this case, we're going to use what we learned from previous sections, which is that ds can equal the square root of 1 plus z partial x plus z partial y squared dA. So what we have to do next is find a plane equation of the form z equals so that we can take the partial derivatives. So we already have that the normal vector is 2, 4, 2. You can put, if you consider the normal vector a, b, c, it's ax plus by plus cz equals d, and that will give you the equation of a plane as long as you have a point, which we do. We have 3 points. So we can go ahead and plug everything in. So it's going to be 2x plus 4y plus 2z equals d. Let's use the point, for example, 2, 0, 0. It doesn't matter which one we use. That's going to give us 4 plus 0 plus 0 equals d. So we have the equation 2x plus 4y plus 2c equals 4. And from that equation, we can just solve for c pretty simply. So we're going to subtract 4 minus 2x minus 4y and then divide by 2. So c equals 2 minus x minus 2y. And now we can plug that into this formula. So we have 1 plus the partial of z with respect to x is 0 minus 1 plus 0 squared plus partial of z with respect to y will be negative 2 squared. dA, and that will give us 1 plus 1 plus 4, which will give us square root of 6 dA. So now we are again ready to plug everything into our formulas. So we have negative 6, negative 3, negative 1 dot with 2 over square root 24, 4 over square root 24, and 2 over square root 24. Then we have square root of 6 d, oops, let me scoot over so we have some more room. So it's going to be square root of 6 dA, and that's all a double integral over a plane. To make this easier, I would just distribute this square root of 6 over the square roots 24, and then if you do that, you just get 1/2. So this all simplifies. If you just put a 2 under the denominator, and this will again simplify to 1, 2, 1. So I would just do that before doing the cross product because it makes it easier in the end. And this surface integral is pretty simple. If we just consider when z equals 0, we have, from the plane equation we already have, we have 0 equals 2 minus x minus 2y. We can solve for either one. I went ahead and solved for y, so 2y equals 2 minus x, y equals 1 minus 0.5x. So if we plug that in here, we have y goes from 0 to 1 minus 0.5x, and x goes from 0 to 2. So again, we know that from the points. Okay, so if we do the dot product, that's going to give us negative 6. Minus 6 minus 1, and that gives us negative 13 from 0 to 1 minus 0.5x, and from 0 to 2, that's going to be dy dx. Then again, that's a very simple double integral. If we plug that in, we just get negative 13, 1 minus 0.5x, and that's from 0 to 2 dx. Let's distribute. Plus 13 over 2x, 0 to 2 dx. Take the integral, so that's going to be negative 13x plus 13x squared over 4, and that's from 0 to 2. So plugging in 2, we're going to get negative 26 plus 13 times 4 over 4, so that's going to be negative 13 minus. Plugging in 0, we get 0. So our final answer is negative 13.